Good morning, everybody. Sunday the 6th. And as you can see from my little bowl and bunch on the table, we are coming to the very end of our tomato growing season, which has been, yet again, fantastic. Bits and bobs ripening, as you can see here. I think they'll do all right without getting cut off. The top lot, I'm not quite sure, may have to go into the plastic greenhouse, and those ones there I don't hold out much hope for, because the mornings and the evenings are getting rather nippy. And the same with these ones. So we have a mixture of the red pear and plum. This again is a red pear, but the ones at the top will not be, will more than likely not come to anything. And I don't know if you can see that in the background. Wait to see if I can zoom in, guys. I thought I had a smaller sunflower than that, but that might, or could be, the smallest sunflower that I've got. And hey, I could put that into hashtag sunflower challenge 2020, I think. Because, for the simple reason, it is indeed in a container, as it must be the smallest one. So there we go, there's another one. Two into the challenge, as it is in a container. I just pop into the plastic greenhouse here. Yesterday evening, I did indeed cut back a couple of tomato plants, and we do have some on a string to ripen inside here. The rest of the tomato plants are indeed, like everything else, coming to an end. I don't know if they'll come to anything either, those plums, but that was a shop-bought one, and that one there was a shop-bought one, as you can see by the tags. And there's potatoes, but we're not doing potatoes today, so back to the tomato with the sun, and it is a red pear again. Still with flowers on, I'm just going to leave it sitting there until such times it dies off. If you just excuse me for a minute to kill my dog. So this is a bit that I was focusing on last night, as it was really red hot yesterday. That's a dahlia, which I've cut down two of those tomato plants, which actually were enormous and put out loads. That is the new chickens and our hens intermingling. So check on them in a momento. That's another dahlia, but the dahlias have been putting on tons and tons of growth. As you can see, that is one plant. But very few flowers due to the heat. So hopefully now it's cooled down, we shall get some nice flowers off that plant, which actually do dinner plate size flowers. And then we're going here into the main tomato plot, and as you can see there as well, all coming to an end. I'm thinking that those ones there will definitely ripen on the plant. I've picked what I could yesterday, so I'll give them another couple of days. They should be alright, and then I'll get this all cleared out. There's some intermingling lettuce in there. And this morning, just after 8 o'clock, I cleared this bed here, which had some Marmont tomatoes in it, which really did not do too well in here. So I gave it a good soak about an hour ago. Beetroot foragey, or forager, I think it is, a French variety. And further along we do have some Swiss chard and pak choi, which will now come into their own because of the cooler weather. Those six lettuce in that I got yesterday, so that's this morning's task. Right, so there's the six again, I shown you yesterday, there is no name on them at all. And I found a couple of stragglers. I know they look really sorry for themselves, but they were in the plastic greenhouse, but I'm going to pop them in as well and see how they got on. So up there I've got a, oh ouch, I have got a gooseberry up my bum. So let's start with these wee ones here first. From seed, I can't remember the variety of these either. Let's try these and get these ones in, because I'm not going to do anything in that little tray, so they may as well take the chance in here. And I'm going to cover these actually. I'm going to cover them all, as it's not to be too hot today at all, as it's not the warmest of mornings. But then again, it's not even 9 o'clock. Oop. Yes, they don't look too hot, these ones. But we shall see how they do. So I'll just go on with this, guys, and have a wee look at the end. Some lovely, nice, fresh lettuce and a few little seedlings all in there. I didn't water them afterwards as I had soaked the ground. And these are not going to stand much of a chance out here, as you all realise, guys, because of the cooler weather. So give them a little chance and get them in the house, as I usually do take them in the house when I'm finished with them outside anyway. And as I've said before, they keep going. So fingers crossed these ones here will keep growing also. Oh la la. Looks as if they were searching for a wee drink as well. But the compost that's in the bottom of these tubs is fresh and it's not wet, but it is damp. Now look, I do indeed think it was in search for some water. Yesterday it was an absolute scorcher. Now, when you're doing chilies, do not put them into a great big enormous tub, as they actually do like a somewhat bit of a tight fit. So that should be alright in there. Let's see if we can get some of this damp compost, and I shall give them a little drink. I didn't know or didn't realise they were as dry as that, but that's what I'm saying. 1 or 2 days of the very hot heat again, guys, and my garden has been suffering, as you have seen and already know. So there we are, that's that one. And I'll give that a little drink, and before it goes up the stairs, I shall top it up with a little bit of hemp straw. said, guys, we'll look back in a couple of days up in the bathroom and we'll see how they got on. There's my lovely sunflower. For the sunflower challenge. In the pot, behind the wall, in the courtyard. Just to finish off, everybody, they are the four little chilli plants, feeling very, very sorry for themselves. And hopefully they'll pick up now, once I've fed and watered them, and they are the lettuce that's in. So not bad.
Toodle pip.
Say bye-bye, honey bun. Bye-bye.